Hello everybody, welcome to Combo Pro e-content production. I am Mubin Sheikh and today I am gonna show you the practical or the tutorial of how to e-sketch the mitosis. First of all, let's watch that video, the inside of which that sketch is there, or the sketch which we are today interested in. Thank you very much. Okay, welcome back once again. So the video which you have seen, just the sketch inside of which is created by using the PowerPoint presentation. So I will show you that presentation first of all. Okay, then I will show you the tutorial on how to e-sketch that. I will just show you that tutorial right from scratch, right from this desktop. So here you can clearly see my name here, or my channel name Combo Pro here. Okay. And my presentation is here, right over this desktop. Okay, so I will just double click it and I will just open it out like this. Okay, and we'll just adjust my video here. Okay, so in order to show you practically, we will just work out on the practical itself, means the presentation itself. Okay, let's show me first of all that apparently video shows only one slide or only one frame, right? But in order to make that or create that, I just used 18 slides. These pretty number of slides I used, okay, in order to create it in one frame or one slide. Okay, now in order to give that effect, you need to use just the transition here. Transitions and animations, okay, and design and draw the and insert, especially these four tabs are important. Okay, so let's work out on the first slide here. So here you can see the cell and the nucleus. Okay, and here you can see the dots, means the cytoplasm, and this chromatin material, and this interface, and this here the name or the topic of that sketch, and the name of the creator. Okay, so all these data is found on this first slide. Okay, if I show you the animation tab here by clicking just this animation tab and just click here the animation pane. Okay, so you can see on only one slide, okay, this much of only data is found on, or content is found on this slide. But for this I used all these animations, so you can clearly see here all these animations are required. Okay, but before giving animation, just let's draw it again, right? So what I will do is, first of all, I will just cancel out this animation pane and just go in insert menu, which is found on the menu bar. I think you might have known about this, and then just go to shape inside that menu, take this oval and draw like this. Fine, now it is a solid circle, right? Solid oval. So you need to just format it likewise. Just go to shape fill and say here no fill, click to the no fill. Fine, and shape outline, just make it larger or just thicker like this. Okay, for 4.5 points. So it looks better now. Fine, so inside of which nucleus needs to be drawn, and for the purpose of which we will again go to insert and then click to shape here, and then here the circle, and inside of which draw the circle like this. Okay, or you can simply, okay, my favorite shape is here, this is that line, okay, or which is called as the scribble freedom. Okay, this is the arc, okay, this is that line, this is called as the curve, and this is the straight line. So you can use this one, okay, and you can draw like this, okay, and then go to shape outline and make its thickness larger like this, okay, and just copy and paste it over it, and just revolve it like this, okay, rotate it, and again you can control C and control V, again you can rotate it likewise here, again you can control C and V, and here you can rotate it likewise in order to look it as a circular shape. Okay, why it needs to be drawn like this? Because we need to show here that nuclear pore as well. Okay, that's why we are taking all these painstaking activity. Okay, fine, like this. So it is somewhat looking like now the nucleus. Okay, everything is the schematic representation. And why don't we take this shape instead of this one? Because here you can take this as well. Just format it here. Format in format. You need to just use this no fill effect, and then in shape outline again make its linings thicker. Okay, and then in shape outline only dashes. Okay. Like this, in order to show you, so as to, you know, represent the nuclear pore, you can also show this, but it is exactly very uniformly structured nucleus. Okay, so so as to show you as a sketch, okay, we are taking this one. Okay, so you can take this also if you want very neat and tidy nucleus. Okay, for the purpose of which I will just delete it so far, and I will just take this inside of which here cell. Okay, arrange it properly here, and then this scribble again, take these lines and draw anyhow. You can just give this task to your small kid or baby if you have. Okay, personally I have drawn actually, if you are having an equation. Okay, fine. So this is the scribble, so three times or two times is okay, fine. So here you can see like this, fine. So it is looking like now the chromatin material. Now the cytoplasm, now this is the very painstaking task, trust me. Okay, so here what you need to do is that first of all insert and text box. Okay, yes, you need to take the text box and just press that dot button on your keyboard, this single dot, fine, and control C it and control V like this. Is it clear? Arrange it properly here. Now you can see control C and control V again here. Fine, you can just take it here right over this inside that cell membrane, and just arrange it properly like this, fine. Now you can do this you can just practice it, or you can try this at an individual level as well. Okay, or second one means one short form means shortcut is also there. Okay, you just go into the format here, but it is it will look the cytoplasm very dense here. Okay, if we give this effect, okay, format shape, and inside the format shape here you can just use this fill button. Okay, this fill menu here, and inside of which the pattern fill. Okay, so pattern fill, so it is now looking like this. Everything is uniformly and neat and tidy, but actually apparently if you want to show like a sketch or inside of the cell, it is not that uniform, you know. So
So it is also occupying that nuclear region as well. Fine. So we will just take this like this only, or our old method, traditional method. Now what I want to show you here, that in second slide you need to mimic like that, or you need to represent like that this chromosome, okay, in interphase and in early prophase the condensation and thickening process goes on, okay. So due to the condensation and thickening, these chromosome only, these linings, thin linings, are becoming here thicker, okay, in early prophase. So how can you simulate it? Okay, the correct word is the simulation here. So how can you show this? That you have to draw this structure in second slide only, first of all, and then in first slide, if you can see, okay, I have just made it like this, inside of which only you can see this chromosome, okay, inside of this nucleus, okay, in between of this, or I will just zoom it out, then you can clearly see here. I will just zoom it out, okay, and here I will just select. Okay, so after zooming, you can see here inside of which I have hidden this chromosome, okay, this one is this, okay. And I have just colorized it as white, so I will black it. Okay, this is the text color, actually the format and shape fill, okay, or shape outline simply. And here you can see the shape outline is the chromosome, okay. So it is in the first slide. Here we are in the first slide, okay. I have just hidden it, or you can see here, I can also give as a black color like this, so it is looking like now the chromosome. So you have to draw this chromosome first of all. How to draw this? So here I will show you in zoom only, that here like this, okay, and here like this, okay, fine. So this is the one sister chromatid, like suppose, okay, and continuously means uniform, you have to draw like this only. And again here, and take it in downward manner and complete this, right? So you can now shape fill here, shape outline, okay. So you have to draw this chromosome like this, fine. You can fully color it also. So you have to make it like this smaller and hide it somewhere, okay, which can't be seen in the first slide. This is what we can say, the chalaki, that you have to do this, okay. But pain is there, okay. So make it white and shape also white, okay. And in between of these two slides, what you need to do is, in the second slide, just arrange these four chromosomes properly here, the same chromosomes, okay. These four chromosomes, we have hidden four chromosome in here in the first nucleus, okay, in the first slide only. I will just wipe this out now, delete it. So these four chromosomes have hidden inside the first nucleus, or the slide, first slide, okay. And in between of these two slides, first and second slide, the transition effect you need to use. Inside the transition, you have to use the morph effect, okay. This is the morph effect, this one is the morph, and here inside of which you can show here the object, okay. So this is how it can now come in this second cell, okay, or early prophase stage, okay, from this to this. So it is looking like this, and in video only it shows in one frame only, fine. Now in third slide, okay, so these what we can say, the centrioles, okay, it moves apart here like this and it goes to respective poles here, okay. In fourth slide you can see here the north pole or south pole, suppose, right? So it goes by moving. If I show you the effect, okay, so here it looks like this, okay. So how to do this? So in second slide only, first of all, you have to draw this thing, all structure, okay. This is not the uniform structure. I have drawn all this structure, okay. So first of all, you have to take this oval, okay. I will just separate it out here like this. Or you can see here in third slide, how did I draw here? See, like this, okay. This is the oval, this is the centriole, okay, and this is here what we can say, these are the spindle fibers are forming, okay. So centrioles, and this is that asteric like appearance, okay. Everything you need to show here, and you have to select all this, you have to select all this and group it together. Like here, in format, you have to group. Okay, now already I have grouped, so I will just ungroup it. So here you can see the individual. Okay, this individual section. So now I ungrouped, so I will show you the individual structures. So you need to draw all these structures by using the oval shape, only shape only. Okay, lines and shapes. Okay, and the centriole inside of which also have drawn, like, okay, and I have made it smaller. Fine. So, and to this I had given this effect. Okay, in shape option, if you go like here, so the background has been given from this. Here you can see the pattern fill. Pattern fill is there. Is it clear? So in pattern fill, you can choose any pattern like this. Okay, this one is also there, or you can change this texture like this. Okay, but the most appropriate I can see here, this can also be the suitable proper. Okay, so I will just control set it everything. Okay, so this is how you have to draw. Okay, and you have to select it right from this corner to this corner. You have to select it and you have to group it together. Okay, in format, group it together, so it will now act as a one object. Okay, this is now one object. Is it clear? So after drawing, in the second slide you have to draw and you have to animate it, okay, right from by giving this animation, okay, right from left to right, you have to give you have to animate it. And in third slide you have to duplicate it, okay. This second cell you have to duplicate and keep this cell here only as a late prophase. Fine. So whatever these structures are there now, so you have to copy this here and paste over this as a one unit. Okay, this structure you have to copy, but you have not to show to your audience that you have copied it over here. Fine. So this one is here and this one is here. Okay, nobody will see this. Fine, as one object. And in third slide again, you have to give transition, that is a morph effect. So right from that second slide, it will transist in a smooth manner like this. Okay, so it will come to the north and south pole. Okay, similarly here in the fourth slide or sixth slide, so you can draw here metaphase. Fine. So you have to use the same chromosomes here, same chromosomes, and you have to arrange it in an equatorial plane. Okay, like you might have known that metaphase shows. Okay, and the spindle fibers. So these linings you have to enlarge it, and some new linings you have to draw from insert shape only. You have to draw these linings. Fine, like this. Okay. And you have to complete this here, insert, okay, shape, and here this linings, and again here like this. Fine. So complete this across that cell, and in next slide you have to take copy paste it, okay, this metaphase stage, because you have to show the changes inside this. That's why you have to take the same one, okay, same cell. Again you have to take next slide only. In seven slide only you have taken as it is, this metaphase as it is, okay. And in eighth stage what you can do is you have to draw now, okay, you have to draw this structure in here. In seventh slide only you have to put, see now, such structures over of this chromosome. That is only sister chromatids, because sister chromatids are gonna be separated here. That clear? And this one, but while putting you have not to show that this chromosome is something different, okay. So same shape you have to draw like this. So what you can see, you can just separate it, cut this, crop this, and you can make these two sister chromatids. Fine. Now what you can do is that in 8th slide, what you can see here in next slide, that you have to take this you know, that sister chromatids towards their respective poles, okay, north and south pole. Fine. So again in next slide you can just copy this and paste here, okay, and just copy and paste there and give transition as a zero time effect, and here draw the nucleus around this, okay, in next slide, okay. And you have to decrease the size of these cis spindle fibers more, okay, than the previous slides. And likewise again go to the 12th, 13th, okay, copy paste it, okay, inside here simply draw that circle, okay. And here you have to take the draw option and this pen option, and inside of with the white option. So after drawing that oval, you can wipe here this, okay, two ovals or two circles, okay, join this, but you have to show the gap like this, or cytokinesis process, okay, constriction or deepening. So you can just draw like this, okay, white color. Fine. Or you can erase also. So here you can now draw the linings also. Now in next slide what you can do is that make these two separate ovals complete, in order to show two completely formed or two fully formed daughter cells, okay. But the main part in this presentation is the animation, okay. So while giving animation you have to select all these parts separately, okay, in order to give that animation, right. So in animation just select this one, select this, select this, okay, and then animate it, appear like this, or wipe, okay, split, floating. So entrance effect you can give. So animation, transitions, draw and insert, all these menus are important in order to show this e-sketch or digital sketch. It's not that easy actually to be seen, because we ever see it in 2 minutes or 1.5 minute, 1 minute, or this is the video for 1 minute, but I took 2 nights, okay, in order to create this. So if you're able to do this, then I just left meiosis for you, and I am also going to create it, okay, within 2 to 3 days. So we can see our the next some of the effects which if you demand me, then we can show a tutorial for those videos as well. Till that time, give me permission. Thank you very much. we will meet in the next video. If you are new to my channel, please subscribe, like it, and share it. Bye-bye.